What's going on, everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today, nope, this is not going to be another Infinite Magic Raid video, but don't worry, because I'm pretty sure that the players that are watching my current Infinite Magic Raid videos are going to say, Aptoide, what the hell are you doing? You are playing a game with Mushroom, right? And yes, I am. And this is fun because this is completely different than Infinite Magic Raid, the game I'm normally playing, but that game is pretty fun. And in fact, it's not only about the basic gameplay you are currently watching on the screen. Yes, you have a hero, this is a mushroom, and the design is not for everyone, right? But the game is pretty funny and is pretty optimized, in fact. And you have some strategy aspects such as many skills and stats you can have on your hero, on your mushroom, and you have some pals that you can use with you, and not the pals from Pal World, but pals mean some friends, in fact, and this is the little creatures that are fighting with me. So the fights can be done in auto but also in manual, so you can decide what skill you want to use and when you want to use them. So this is the strategic aspect of the game also, because you have many stats and you have many things such as the stun percentage rate on your gear. Yes, you have that on your gear. You have some HP, attack, defense, attack speed, crit rate, skill damage. You have also some combo regeneration percentage. This is the speed, the HP you are going to regen per second. And you have many other stuff that you can manage. Some counter strikes, so every time you're gonna take some hit, you are gonna be able to counter attack. Many strategic things, okay? Apart of that, you can have your champion, your mushroom. You have many skills, and this is the gacha part of the game. You have a lot of coupons that you can spend in that content to summon some skills to enhance the damage of your character, or some pals that you can summon to fight alongside with you. So if you have a look to the skills, for example, the ones I equipped, I'm gonna summon a spider dealing some AoE damage every second, so you have some dots as well in the game. You have some AoE damage directly to imprison them. You can lower their speed. You can have many strategic things in that game, and I do love that. You can increase your skills by doing that. And you have a class to change on your hero. In fact, every time you are going to level up, you are going to be able to evolve your hero, your mushroom. And so for now, he looks like a mushroom only, but in the future, he's going to look like this, because you have many classes. And for example, once I'm going to reach the level 50, my little mushroom is going to look like that, depending on the class I decided to pick. And I decided to pick the mage class, so I'm going to be able to specialize into a healer or a spellcaster, and it does matter, because you have a content in which you have to fight alongside other players, and they can have different kind of classes. I'm gonna show that to you. So you have the dungeons, you can farm the two first ones to get some extra gear and experience on your hero with the first one, or the second one you can get some more coupons to summon skills and pals to fight with you, and the final one you can get some extra stuff to get more artifacts to equip on your hero. So for example, there, this is a 3 player content. So you can invite your friends to fight alongside with you. So this is the difficulty number 2. And you can also random matchmaking. So this is what I'm gonna do. And as you can see, you have other units. So I am a mage. I'm here to deal some damage to enemies, and the others are there maybe if there is a healer or a tank, something like that. It's gonna matter in the future depending on the difficulty of the contents you are gonna fight inside. This is interesting for that game, right? I wasn't expecting that when I had the first look to the game, though. I thought that it was only in auto, and that was just a basic mushroom game with pretty mushrooms, in fact, but that's not everything. And I'm pretty enjoying the game so far, so I'm curious to discover more, and I'm gonna play a bit more during the month and cover more videos about that game. You have multiple waves, and then you have the boss wave at the end. And look at that guy. That player is losing a lot of HP. I am not, because probably I have more gear. I am dealing more damage than him, and so I'm losing less HP. And that guy, he's a bit better than us, apparently. Another mage, I guess. And then the boss wave. And so you have also some stats such as the evasion, and so you have some chances to dodge an attack. So you have many things to take into consideration when it comes to stats with your on your hero. Okay, then the boss is dead and I am gonna add that guy to my friend list, and I get some items that I can use in that menu to find some other relics. So I'm gonna try to get some more, and here I have some skill crit rate 5% more. So in the future, I'm gonna unlock more spaces to get more artifacts, more relics, and increase a bit higher my damage. And you have other stuff in the game. So you have the lamp. This is the basic feature of the game. Every time, over time, you are gonna get some equipment. You can click there, check the equipment, equip it. And the way to get some experience in the game is to sell some gear you obtain. So every time you are gonna sell, you are gonna get both gold and experience, as you are gonna see right there. You can level up your lamp using some gold that you acquire over time. And depending on the level of your lamp, you are gonna acquire better gear also as well. And you have an auto feature, because as you can see, I have 645 lamps, and of course I'm not gonna click 645 times. So once you reach the level 16, I guess you have to play a bit less than 10 minutes to reach the level 16, then you are gonna unlock that cogwheel. You can set up the items you want to sell directly. So for example, I want to keep only the quality well and above, and you have all these rarities of gear. So every time I'm gonna have a blue gear or something above, it's gonna stop, it's gonna show the item to me, and then I'm gonna decide whether I want to keep it or sell it. So you have other filters. For example, in the future, I'm gonna want to target only crit rate items. So I'm gonna pick that, and you have other stuff like that. You can see you have crit rate, combo, counter strike, stun, evasion, regeneration, skill crit, many stats, and so you can select everything you want. And so it's gonna basically sell everything you are gonna obtain. So I'm gonna pick rare and above, click on start, and it's gonna automatically sell all the items under the rarity I picked. Okay, so that one is purple, so I have to choose whether if I want to keep it or sell it, and this is what I'm gonna do. So in that game, you can join some guilds, and this is the guild content. So you have a hall in which you can have a look to your guild members. You can help them to do some tasks. You can do some donations. You can see the list. You can have a boss fight, a daily boss fight. In fact, every 7 or 8 hours, you can fight that boss to get some extra rewards. So I'm gonna challenge it, for example. And you have multiple levels, and so the higher the damage you can do, the better the rewards you are going to obtain at the end. So you can leave the fight all the time, no matter the dungeon you are fighting in, and it's not going to consume the stamina needed to enter the fight, and that's great. So if you are near the end, you can leave and then restart later during the days, and this is what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna do my battle later, because we are early in the morning today, and I'm planning to save my entry to try to do more damage during the day. So you have more content, you can unlock that later. So I haven't cleared yet the stage normal 510 in the story. You have the family shop. You are gonna get some medals that you're gonna be able to use in that shop to get more items. And you have more content that are gonna come later, such as that one, for example, it's in construction apparently. Or that one in the top left corner, you have the family brawl, it's not open yet. And you have the family schedule, you have a treasure hunt, I don't know what it is yet. So apparently it's daily and it has a fixed hour, so I'm gonna have to wait until it opens. So you can manage your pals there, you can enhance them, you need multiple copies of them in order to unlock them. You can quick equip them to your team, but as you can see, they have different stats and they are increasing your stats as well. So it's important to choose the right ones in order to increase your power. And then you have some kind of mini games and things that you can enhance. For example, you have the mine. In the mine, you have to dig up to get some materials. For example, here I have some ore, I have some coupons to summon some pals, etc. And you have some items that you can use to destroy things, such as that one, for example, that is breaking everything. You can find some when you are digging up. So I'm gonna collect some more ore. You don't care about that, and you are not supposed to hit these gray stuff, otherwise you are gonna lose your pickaxes. So collect only the ore and try to go down. And I'm gonna go down and I'm gonna use the other stuff there. You're gonna see, oh, I'm gonna do that. Okay, I fucked up. This is not what I wanted to do, so I'm gonna use a bomb there and I'm gonna collect that with a pickaxe. I'm gonna dig up a bit more. I'm gonna do another one, and now I'm gonna use that item. So I'm gonna dig all the way up to there, and you have some advertisements in the game for many, many things. For example, for the minigame, if you want another drill, you can just basically watch an ad, and it's gonna take maybe, what, 30 seconds, and you are gonna get another drill for free. You have the same for the pickaxes and for the bombs, two times each. You have many other adverts in the game, and so if you want to watch them, it's okay for you, but you have a pack that you can buy for 18 euros, and forever, you are gonna be able to skip all the ads. 11 euros only, and if you are using Aptoide, this is the equivalent of the Play Store that you can find on Android, or you can install it on an emulator. This is what I'm doing currently on the screen, and I am playing on MSI App Player. The link to download it is in the description of the video, as well as the link to download Aptoide and the AppCoins wallet. So let me introduce that to you, so you are gonna start saving a huge amount of money when you are gonna spend in the game if you want to. So if you are using Aptoide, you are gonna save a ton of money. For example, that pack is gonna cost to me 32 euros, and I'm gonna get a ton of things to help me daily in the game. If I click on there, it's gonna open Aptoide because I installed it on my emulator. And so if you want to buy a pack using Aptoide, this is the price of the pack. For example, 32 euros. Using Aptoide, you are gonna get 5 euros in cashback that you are gonna be able to reuse to buy another pack for free. And if you are using my promo code Mushroom, as written on the screen to the right, you are gonna get 5% extra cashback on every purchase in game. So there, instead of 5 euros, I'm gonna get 6 euros and 71 cents as cashback after buying that pack. So let's do that and let's check what I'm gonna be able to do with that cashback. There we go. I just bought the pack and I got my cashback. I got the things inside of the pack. And now who knows, let's say that maybe I want to buy that one, it costs 5 euros, so I'm just gonna click there, it's opening Aptoide, I'm gonna select another payment method, I'm gonna select the AppCoin credits, it's showing when you have enough cashback on your AppCoin's wallet to buy the pack in question, so that one cost 5 euros, and thanks to the cashback I earned by buying the previous pack, I'm able to buy that one for free. And there we go, another pack, and that one was free. So if you have any question about Aptoide, how to install it, how to use it, how to install the AppCoins wallet to get your cashback, feel free to contact me. My ID Discord is to the right of the video and in the description below. You have also a video guide to install Aptoide and to get it work on your computer or on your smartphone. So feel free to watch it. The link is in the description of my video as well. So so far I'm pretty enjoying the game. It's pretty fun. The designs are pretty cool in my opinion. This is not for everyone, of course, but I think that in the future it's gonna get more strategic thanks to all the skills and the pals I'm gonna use and the stats of my hero with the gear, etc. And we are gonna have more content to do, so it might be really nice to play the game at least during that month. So we are gonna see more content on that on my channel in the future. I hope you enjoyed that video. If it's the case, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. Oh, and I almost forgot to say, but we have also as well a PvP mode, so you have to go there to pick an opponent and then you are fighting against him on the ring with some mushrooms, having a look to your fights in behind. That's pretty funny, right? So you have to battle and then you are gonna get some extra rewards at the end of the fight if you win or not. So I get some more items, experience, and also some more coupons to skip some features in the game. So that was all for the video. Have a nice day. See you soon. Bye bye.